In the summer of 1963, the sweltering heat shimmered off the tarmac at Prospect Airfield in Moscow, where a revolution in military aviation was about to unfold. Hidden away in a dimly lit hangar was a Yak-36, a pioneering Soviet experiment in VTOL technology. Its sleek, dart-like silhouette set against the backdrop of Cold War tensions hinted at the ambition and ingenuity behind this remarkable aircraft. Far from the conventional fighter bomber of its time, this innovative machine was designed by the Yakovlev Design Bureau under the guidance of Alexander Yakovlev and the technical expertise of Sergei Tumansky. The single-seater was a marvel of futuristic design. Its fuselage was streamlined, tapering to a sharp nose that housed advanced avionics and a large canopy, providing the pilot with an unobstructed view. The aircraft's body was crafted with a combination of aluminum alloys and lightweight composites, chosen for their strength and durability, an aerodynamic marvel. What set this aircraft apart from others was its advanced propulsion system. It employed a modified R-19-300 engine, a product of Tumansky's innovative engineering. This engine was fitted with swiveling jet nozzles, allowing the aircraft to transition from vertical takeoff to horizontal flight with remarkable agility. The nozzles, housed in sturdy, angular nacelles on either side of the fuselage, were a defining feature, giving it a menacing yet elegant appearance. The vision for this aircraft stemmed from a desire to overcome the limitations of traditional jets, which required long runways and were disadvantaged in combat scenarios. Yakovlev and Tumansky sought to create a fighter that could operate from short, makeshift airstrips or even from the decks of ships. Their goal was to design an aircraft capable of taking off and landing vertically, thus expanding the strategic options available to the Soviet military. The development journey was marked by both triumphs and setbacks. Initially conceived as a single-seat prototype to test the boundaries of VTOL technology, the early stages of the project revealed the complexities of achieving stable hover and controlled flight in a jet aircraft. Despite these challenges, Yakovlev and his team pressed on, driven by the potential of their groundbreaking concept. Originally known as Product B, this aircraft was the Soviet Union's experimental foray into VTOL aviation. The first prototype, simply numbered number 36, was designed for endurance and engine protection tests. Engineers worked tirelessly to refine the aircraft's aerodynamics and control systems. The following prototypes, number 37 and 38, played pivotal roles in the development of VTOL capabilities. Prototype number 37 was used for initial hovering trials, performing tethered hover maneuvers to master the delicate balance of VTOL flight. Over 85 successful hovering tests within 2 years marked significant progress. Prototype number 38 focused on fine-tuning the jet rudders and control systems, ensuring that the pilot could maintain precise control during hover and transition phases. These refinements were crucial for the successful execution of VTOL operations. The culmination of these efforts came in 1964, when test pilot Valentin Mukhin achieved the first conventional takeoff and landing. Mukhin achieved the first free hover and transition to horizontal flight. This aircraft had taken a monumental step towards proving the viability of VTOL flight. However, the ultimate test, a complete vertical takeoff, sustained hover, and smooth transition to horizontal flight, was accomplished in 1966, marking it as a true VTOL aircraft. Despite these achievements, the aircraft faced challenges that ultimately limited its impact. The Soviet military had high expectations for VTOL capabilities, but the payload capacity fell short of what was required for an operational combat aircraft. The military's concerns about its utility in real combat scenarios dampened enthusiasm for the project. However, this experimental VTOL aircraft was not a failure. Rather, it was a crucial step in the development of VTOL technology. While it might not have become the mainstay fighter the Soviets envisioned, its legacy remains significant. Packing a punch with a top speed of 1,000 kilometers per hour, 621 miles per hour, and a service ceiling of 12,000 meters, 39,370 feet, it was a marvel of engineering for its time. However, its relatively short range and limited payload capacity of 100 kilograms, 220 pounds per hardpoint were drawbacks due to the high fuel consumption required for VTOL operations. The key to its VTOL prowess lay in its two Soyuz Tumansky R27-300 vectored thrust axial flow turbojet engines. These powerful engines, each generating 51.993 kilonewtons, 11,688 pound-feet of thrust with afterburner, were the heart of the aircraft's innovation. The lessons learned laid the groundwork for future advancements in the field. Through this program, the Yak-38 would go on to serve as the Soviet Navy's first operational VTOL aircraft, bridging the gap between experimental technology and practical application. Though it didn't become the mainstay fighter its creators hoped for, it remains a testament to the Soviet Union's commitment to exploring new frontiers in aviation. Its design and the principles it tested continue to inspire modern VTOL technologies.